seat to Jane Guzman with her topic, "That's My Day, Dad." Jane Guzman, "That's My Dad."
Have you ever had a wardrobe malfunction?
What?
Yes. Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters and my friends, my dad was a magnet for malfunctions. Growing up with him, there was not a question of if something would go wrong, it was more when and how much it would go wrong. As children, my two brothers and I, my elder brother Lawrence was 12, I was 9, my younger brother Alistair was 7. We were taken to Shetland to renovate a little cottage. This cottage here, you can see it is in the middle of nowhere. It's in the middle of a bog. Now, for those of you that don't know what a peat bog is like, it is the smelly, squidgy, damp, disgusting, quicksand type place. You have to be careful how you walk over the bog in case you disappear. Scottish people, however, are born with an uncanny knack for bog walking. Dad didn't get that memo. We were walking across the bog, having climbed the fence to get to the cottage. Dad steps on a nice, green, firm-looking piece of turf and sinks down past his knees.
"Help me, kids, I'm falling in the bog." "Grab the cookies."
I went to grab the cookies. They disappeared. The bog monster had eaten them. Lawrence pulled one arm. Alistair pulled the other arm. He couldn't get my dad out of the bog. He was stuck. I'll help. I got there and I pushed my dad's knees, and I pushed my dad's knees, and I fell in the bog. I was not amused. I was a 9-year-old girl. I don't like being stinky and smelly, and I hated my brothers for laughing at me. I hate all boys anyway. They're just stupid. Decorum. I'm going to clean my dad's trousers and dry them for him. I get his trousers, I hang them on the mantelpiece, and I put them under a clock. They're drying by the peat fire. There we go.
Oh no! His trousers are burning!
Dad, would you like a cup of tea? Tea is the answer to all problems.
No, thanks. I'm okay. I'm busy doing my sermon for the church tomorrow.
Dad, I burnt your trousers.
Oh, that's okay, lass. Don't worry. I've got another pair of trousers I can put on for tomorrow.
Now, I have no idea, but my dad decided to leave his Bible and the sermon notes under a dry stain dike, which is this dike here beside the church. Maybe he was afraid of falling in the bog and the bog monster eating his sermon notes. I have no idea. Because in Shetland, it rains a lot. It's not very safe to leave anything outside. Also, there are herds of marauding sheep
that wreck walls and mess everything up. And there are even hungry haggis. Yes, there are haggis in Shetland as well as Scotland. Shetland haggis are solitary animals. They don't like anyone else unless it's mating season. However, they're pretty easy to catch. They have two short legs, two long legs. Short legs on the left, long legs on the right. Which means they only run in an anti-clockwise direction. So the way to get rid of them is putting mirrors on the ground. The haggis runs around, sees the mirror, spins around, falls over, and you can catch them in a bag, and if you're really brave, you can eat the haggis. In the morning, we walk over to church. We go ahead of my dad, he picks up his Bible. We're told, sit down at the back of the church and be quiet. Right, now, unbeknown to us, Dad had climbed the fence where there was wire. Everybody was in church waiting. Ladies in their hats. Gentlemen tied up. Children scrubbed clean. I don't know why they have to go to Sunday school. You go 5 days a week, is that not enough? Dad solemnly walks down the aisle. He's ripped his trousers. These boxers are hanging out the back. Oh no, I'm so old. I can't believe it. I just can't believe it. And everybody had seen as well. What was worse was they were polka dot boxers. That's not an image I would like to remember of my dad. He marched down. He glared at us through the sermon because we were laughing. Everybody was trying not to notice the doctor's boxers. What can we do? You can't unsee something. But I would like to say, if you had a father like mine, would you ever let him out of the house? Or would you do a boxer check first? I don't know.